jug when it hurts like hell. I've never needed anyone so much. There's no one else I love, and I curse myself. 'Cause the right thing is to give you.
Welcome back, everybody. I'm Angel. This is Gaming with Angels, and this is Jack, along with my small harem and Zargo. I decided to skip out on Francois' thing because after I got off of here with you guys, I got just freaking annihilated, and it was actually kind of impressive, like how much I just got my ass totally fucking rocked. So where we're at right now, we're actually here to find the ring to the Nord who is in the Mage's guild, and then we'll go get the Mort Flesh and continue on with what we're doing from here. So I'm gonna go ahead and save at this point. I went ahead and did the traveling and stuff so you guys didn't have to watch. I came across Ebon, so I went in there, found the marketplace, finally found a marketplace, and restocked on a bunch of shit. I have not gone back to Skyrim yet. I'm trying not to, so see if I can do this without going back to Skyrim to restock stuff, and we'll see what happens. So, but I'm going to show you guys a couple of things that I picked up. They had watermelons. Let's take a look here. So I got a half a coconut. That was pretty cool. I have flamed swamp hound. I was able to pick up grapes. Let's see if I can find them here. So I've got purple grapes, green grapes, different types of apples, a honey bun, meat pies. There's all kinds of stuff. Along with teas. So there's the Red Mountain flower tea. Never had that before, so we'll see what happens there. Sweet apple cider. Okay, take it for what it's worth. And so there's that. And so yeah, I definitely took care of that while I was in here. Oh, and then there's a crumble loaf, like half a loaf of bread or something. I don't know. But that's what I've done. So Gemstone Cave. So let's go and make sure that we don't die. Go ahead and put this back on for you guys. That looks good. I'd really like to do is find a marketplace that I can pick up some water, because all of my water skins are empty, and the whole group's water skins, they're all empty too. So all we have
not
is
very
like
welcoming, but I doubt that's the point.
The rock bugs are still moving, so that still freaks me out, just so you guys know. Cages. That was way easier than I thought it would be. And I didn't have to kill nothing. And I have no plans right now of delving deeper into this cave. So let's go see if we can get Mort Flesh. See what we can do about the dog. Okay. We're gonna see if there's anything up here that is relatively close to it that I've already been to, but it's not looking promising. Let's so we'll come back down here to this path. Oh, and in my process of not making you guys have to see all of the traveling and shit, came across a new NPC. The NPC is called Imposters. They show up as Bandit Marauders. And I don't know what that is. Can I take it? I can take it. Okay. They show up listed as Bandit Marauders, but because YouTube likes to cancel my channel because every time somebody shows a piece of side boob, a little Karen loses their shit. There's another one. Oh, it's a zombie. So you get a little side boob going, and all of a sudden, you know, and every Karen in the country is sucking mines, but never mind, I have the decapitation and the blood and everything else. So, and I actually called somebody out on that some time ago. That and that. My bad. Dude. Oh, fuck. Okay. Anyway. And, this broad wasn't having it, so that's actually what ended up happening and why the channel got canceled last time. So, because Serana is sexy as fuck, and apparently that was wrong or something, and called me everything out, saying, one, that I was a dude. That was actually the big problem, because, and that's really pissed her off. Like, okay, I'm not a man, and I am not stooping to your level. And nothing against guys. You guys know I love my dudes, but that was freaking stupid. Like, stupid, stupid. I did not want to cross that bridge. Anyway. So, yeah, that happened. I'm still being attacked by shit. What the fuck? Okay, what is that? Those are like morphy, ghosty thingies that shoot ice spikes. Ow! God damn it! Oh, it's a whisper. Okay, that makes way more sense. Oh. I'll take that. Anyway. It's gonna go that way. Do this real quick. Just so I have the one tracker going. So, yeah, it was crazy. She's like, how could you have this stuff up and let children watch it? And seriously, the comment was, you know, they're not my kids. I don't have control over somebody else's kids. All of my stuff is marked for over 18 years old. You have to put in an age limit for some of my stuff because, you know, of whatever random reason. And, you know, if somebody's 13-year-old is getting onto YouTube and stuff like that, that's not on me. That is called, you should probably be disciplining your children a little bit more than what you are and stop being fucking afraid of whooping some ass. Anyway, so apparently there was no problem with me decapitating things and shedding blood all over the place and using a lot of actual physical visual violence. But, you know, God forbid if, you know, somebody wants to kiss someone else, because apparently that's just fucking taboo. Where are we going? Almost there. Excellent. I need to go up this way a little bit. Oh, here we go. Okay, I think this is where I need to go? All right. It's real simple. If you don't like the channel, don't fucking watch it. Like, literally, it is that simple. You don't like what you're seeing on the channel, don't fucking watch. Go somewhere else. So now these imposters, they show up naked, so I can't show that on YouTube. And when I went to loot them, they had imposter ears. So, like, they had cosplay elf ears or some shit. I don't know, but that's what they were called, is imposter ears.
Wizard casts a fireball in here, and the whole place could come down on our heads.
I'm hearing the skeleton. That's what I was listening to. Oh, shit. That is an ugly-ass fucking spider. Oh, goddammit. Come on. Ah! No! Fuck! Try this again.
One fool of a wizard casts a fireball in here, and the whole place could come down.
That is really ugly. It looks like it came out of Star Trek or Babylon 5. Ah, and that is shocking me. What the fuck? Oh, it's a lich. Nice. Hey, stop it. Get it. Apparently, you can use that as a weapon. As a mace. Makeshift spider, okay. Huh. That's fun. What is this up here? Ooh. really gotta quit doing that shit. Now I gotta wait for this shit to kind of like dissipate so that I can get through there. Damage because I have a feeling this is gonna rock my world. After what happened in Francois, almost done. One more. Excellent. Good job, little Atronach.
My dear, I've been waiting for you. And to think I was worried about you going into the Thalmor Embassy alone.
Oh, I like that one. Hey, I was not done, fucker.
I'm so happy to be with you. Ooh, really? You're serious? For me?
Yes. Get the fuck out of here. Anyway. So, yeah, if you don't have nothing nice to say, don't say nothing at all. And I'm trying to keep it clean for you guys, but I gotta do what I gotta do. One, two, three, four. Okay. Way the hell back over here. Oh, good. Now, that's right, because all both of these are at the Mage's Guild. So I'm going to return the ring, and then we're going to go talk to the master mage, whatever. Anyway, give him the mort flesh. It's congealed. So maybe there's that. And definitely get some sleep.
And it's all thanks to you.
I'm right behind you.
Anyway, so tomorrow is Thanksgiving, and I would like to wish all of you a wonderful, happy Thanksgiving if you're here in the States.
Hail.
What's up?
Thank you.
You're welcome. Okay, ring of nullification removed.
Goodbye.
Deuces. That's it?
Good day.
Anyway, happy Thanksgiving from my house to yours and our studios here at Gaming with Angels. I've been so busy working and getting things done and taken care of. Trying to get Thanksgiving dinner ready. So if that's something that you guys celebrate, right there with you. What's up, Doge?
Well, the Dean taught you teleportation to Somerset, right? Should bring you right to the guild here. If you're outside and want to come back here in a hurry, you can just teleport right to the guild.
Oh, what?
That particular spell wasn't created with that contingency in mind, and could have some negative side effects.
That's fair.
Teleport moves you from one place to another. What happens when you're engulfed in fire? Does the fire come with you?
Okay, that's fair.
What if you had been stabbed? If the blade remained inside of you, it would be conceivable that your attacker could be teleported too. It is just safer to avoid using it in a fight. Well, Kalinda has been given permission to offer her teleportation services. You should speak with her. The big cities all offer teleportation. It is the preferred method of travel, after all. Teleportation has been sanctioned by the Dominion, but some places are still off-limits, like Dusk, for safety reasons. The spells the Dean taught you will teleport you to your college or the guild here in Somerset. Alinor.
He corrected himself.
Dusk was taken over by... well, it isn't protected by the Lilandril Guard or the Dominion. The criminals that escape the prison in Lilandril usually end up here. Thank you. Next, you need to find dried spider silk. Should be some in Nernscar Hollow.
We're gonna go sleepy time. Before we do anything, we're gonna go take a nap.
Hello.
What's up? So if I come out of a cave or something, I can use that Somerset teleportation and it takes me right back to the guild. The fuck, yo. Okay, well, you know what? We're doing it. I'm gonna use it. I'm gonna abuse it. I'm gonna do everything I can.
This is what us Nords were always meant to do. Traverse the province and right wrongs with strength, steel, and... resolve.
Cesargo is eager to hear how the scrolls are working.
Heyo! Oh, excuse me, guys. It's been a long week, so... I kind of want to go get a water keg and
you're
stick it in here.
Somewhere warm,
I might do that.
You are taking us somewhere warm, mate.
Happening. Doing it.
My blood boils every time I think about what happened to Rongar's wife and daughter. I'm glad we gave Mogar
an Alright, everybody should be picking up water skins here. Let's see what happens.
Got your back.
Yep, Kaisa picks up hers. Arania, let's pick it up hers.
You are taking us somewhere warm.
Shut up, Desargo. Okay, that works. And I'm going to
You are taking us somewhere warm, I trust.
Leave that there for now. I mean, I could always go get another one out of the cheat room, which is fine, but I would rather not. If I have one place in the whole freaking province or multiple provinces to get water from, I'll take it, you know?
I detest romancy as is, but I had no idea it could be even more sickening.
Okay, now I gotta go find this dried spider web stuff. Oh, excuse me. I like the rose petals all over the place. That's pretty cool.
Getting used to heavy armor, are you? I can help you get your plates adjusted, if you'd like.
How am I going now? I wonder if she can transport me. Hey, can...
How are you? Actually, I do. This last one will be full of adventure. You can test your magical abilities in a number of different ways.
Archery is a good skill to take up.
You will escort the scholar Arthil from Alinor to a mysterious cave. Well, scholars are not typically skilled in combat, and generally have not invested in a high constitution. Well, I guess it's because she's not really sure where it is.
Oh, for fuck's sake.
I heard that many of the old coral structures have had curses placed on them by the Slowed.
The fuck is the Slowed?
I'll be here.
Yeah, I know, but... I'm just gonna fast travel as much as I can because if I can do that. Oh, excuse me. I don't know where the cave is, and then it gives you a quest marker. That's okay, so over there, can't really see it from here, which is fine, but that is the imposters.
I still can't help but wonder if Ancona went rogue, or if the Thalmor wanted him to do all that.
I don't know, babe. And then when I got into Ebon, which was even better. Come on. You know, you ask about... You ask people what they think about the imposters, and they're like, they're scum of the earth, blah, 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 blah. And they just go off the deep end about them, so.
So, is real armor too heavy for you? I'll just make sure they don't hit you. In all seriousness. You did good with the fit.
Oh, that's a blacksmith.
What does the Nord need? Khajiit is many things. Ah, weapons. Yes. Armor. Yes. Khajiit has nothing for sale, but has lost a most precious heirloom.
I'm more of a heavy armor woman myself.
Smelly man in old forms. This one thinks he has it.
Okay.
I've got your back.
Thanks.
You're taking us somewhere warm, I trust.
We'll see.
Thank you.
still think it's beautifully laid out and stuff. Like, I don't care who you are. This is really pretty. So we're gonna follow this along here, come up, and the next cross will take a left and head north. Apparently. Yeah, head north. And then further north. Okay. I think it's actually going to take us very long to get there. It's just a matter of I haven't traveled enough to have enough places for fast traveling. That's Tiger. Wait, hit the other one. Jesus. Bad Tiger. Bad kitty. Bad kitty. Yeah. God damn it. Do magic here. So, because I have to do magic here, I'm going to have to start increasing my magicka levels.
You don't have magic much, do you? Can't say I blame you. I barely trust any of it myself.
Pretty. Nice, pretty little pond. That was not easy to see, so I know we'll get there eventually. I want to mark this just so it's marked. Go, Weeping Pond. Wow, that is really pretty. Kind of foggy here. Very shadowy because it's between the mountains. And it's only 10 o'clock in the morning. There we go. That is really easy to get split off of and to lose your pathway. Wow. That's actually pretty incredible, to be honest. I'm not gonna lie. Definitely doesn't have the box map effect that just typical Skyrim does, so... What the fuck? Oh shit, that is really big. Damages the target's health by 2,000 points? Yes, please.
I'll kill you when you stand.
I have no idea what they found, but... They get to, oh, they're killing another spider. Okay. I think they're still killing the spider. Well, ladies, Gizargo's not in on it. He's standing right there. Let's go see if we can help. The house right here. What the hell is going on? Oh, I hear a tiger. Oh, what is that? Dead scholar. Feet. Kaisa is chasing something down. I don't know what the hell she's chasing down. Oh, a hunger. She's chasing down a hunger. Okay. Whoa! Come back here, you little fucker. Cure poison discovered from hunger tongue. Neat. Okay. Back to what I was doing, ladies, if you don't mind.
I couldn't ask for anything more than traveling.
Apparently I ate the tongue, and you can cure poison with those. So I'll have to keep that in mind and go pick some up, you know, every time I see a hunger now. That's disgusting, but I'm gonna fucking do it anyway. Nernscar Hollow. Well, here goes nothing. You gotta go around it.
Greetings. You want to know my story? Well, you see, one day, not too long ago, I was walking the path near the old coral ruins, looking for some coral samples, of course. As expected, I stumbled upon this Nernscar here. Wait, I'm getting ahead of myself. My name is Naltharion. I originally hail from Cyrodiil. The culture of Cyrodiil has changed much over the years, and I came to a juncture in my life when I had to make a decision on whether the life there was for me or not. I had made a list on some parchment of what willed me to stay. That list took me several days to finish as I was stuck. Stuck on the very first line. Why was the question? Why was I still there?
Go on.
During this time, I made my way over to the second edition, an underground rare bookshop, and picked up a copy of the most invigorating book, Farmer's Tale. Have you read it? Needless to say, the book absorbed me, regaling in the time of the critical moment. It was then that I realized that I knew so little of my homeland. It was decided. I was off to Somerset Isle to get back to my roots and learn more of this story's couple. The trip was without incident, though I do recommend taking passage on a Cyrodiilic vessel. Quite relaxing. Well, when I arrived at Lelandril, I stopped at the pub for a moment to get grounded from the boat ride. After I was feeling settled, I thought I would look for the couple who were mentioned in the book. I spent years scouring the land, only to discover there was no one with those names that lived here. I concluded that they were given false names, as the book suggested they were not the type to seek fame. Then I got thinking. What if it happens again? That was a terrifying time for all who were there to live it. I never had the means of building any grand structures and no real funds to prepare. I would have to use what the land provided. So, here I am, in a cave full of spiders, breeding them to endure. Not to win battles, but to shield us in the event that misery strikes again.
Okay, so you're training spiders to defend against oblivion.
Not training, breeding. Spiders don't follow commands. I have seen some magic with pet spiders. Some even issue commands like, attack my pets, or dinner is ready. But it is not so. Telling water to fall does not make someone a water wizard. Water falls and spiders bite. The pity is not that the mage has spiders as pets, but that they actually may think they have control over them.
How does that make you any different? I am very confused. So you're breeding spiders because you think there's going to be Oblivion Crisis Part 2.
I don't claim to have camaraderie with arachnids. Did you know that most people think spiders are insects? Arachnids are creatures with 2 body segments, 8 legs, no wings or antennae, and they regurgitate digestive fluids onto their prey to digest.
Unless it's a flying spider, then they do have wings.
I guess you've never seen slug's meat. Now that's disgusting.
Dude! I don't want to know that! Where do slugs come from? Wow!
I guess the same place as spiders. What an odd question. They are indigenous to this area, if that's what you mean. Now, I have much to ponder. It was pleasant speaking with you.
Sure. I apparently still have to find... fuck, that means I gotta go down, I guess, down the ladder? Before I decide to do that... Make sure I didn't miss a hallway here or something. I don't think I did. Nope, down the hole we go. Oh, sweet Jesus. Fuck! Yes, I see you, you big motherfucker. You're like Kaiser-sized spider.
Thank you.
Shit. Sorry, Aranya.
Khajiit got your back.
That's appreciated because... Wow, that is really pretty. Holy shit. Okay, you cannot teleport inside of a dwelling, building, cave, whatever. You have to be outside. Got it.
How do you do, Nord?
Oop. I think she has the hots for me. It's kind of weird. Anyway, we're gonna turn into spider silk and talk to Master Bowling. Find out. What else do we actually need? Because I don't know.
Greetings.
Hot.
Thank you. Next, you need to find ground blood moss. Should be some in Mandas.
Okay. Meeting a lot of crazy fuckers right now. So, anyway, Lydia, beautiful Lydia, Jack, and myself. See you guys next week. Thanks for watching.
distress.